Welcome back for round three. So far, I'm 2-0 with this four-color brew. I'm normally almost militantly against playing four colors in Legacy. I'm a big fan of consistent mana bases and resilience against Wasteland and Blood Moon. But I guess for starters, I'm trying to have a more open mind since four-color decks have been successful for a long time, in particular the everything but white. Delver and Grixis control decks with Deathrite Shaman. Also, Esper Deathblade was popular and successful for a long time. So maybe I'm just being a little too harsh on the four color mana base thing, but also I think I've structured this deck in a way to be as reasonable as possible, and having the 8 mana creatures that can help smooth your mana does make a big difference. So I'm just trying it out and I'll see how I feel. Well, here is a hand with no green mana and 3 green cards. However, I do have a brainstorm, so I think it's worth keeping. I'm on the draw, and my opponent mulliganed to 6, scryed to the bottom. Looks like I'm going to be up against Black Red Reanimator, which I can't imagine is a great matchup. Elesh Norn Tidespout Tyrant. Sure. Reanimate Tidespout Tyrant. So I have Jace is my only way to actually get rid of this from play. So this is going to be a tough game to win. Underground Sea. If my opponent plays no spells, I'll be able to put Jace into play in time. Also, next turn I can brainstorm into a mana creature to try to accelerate the process. Entomb for Sire of Insanity. Yikes. All right, well, I'll brainstorm. There's my noble hierarch. That's what I wanted to see. Hopefully, my opponent's best move is to flashback Faithless Looting here. Or better yet, just do nothing. Okay, I think I've seen enough here. I do get some nice tools off the sideboard, including 2 Rest in Peace. Swords to Plowshares definitely seems better against this version of Reanimator than against the classic blue-black version. Meddling Mage can do something. Probably want all my permission spells. My opponent did have a Bayou, but I wouldn't necessarily expect this deck to have a green land in play all that often. So what's coming out? Definitely the Abrupt Decays. I'll probably sideboard largely the same way as against Sneak and Show. The Stoneforge Mystic package is very lackluster. And then Leovold shuts down Faithless Looting and Grizzlebrand. Probably worth it. Do like Jace. Yeah, a little unclear what's better between Leovold and True Name Nemesis. I'll err on the side of Leovold being better. Cut a couple True Names. Not good enough against a combo deck. This is also not too great, but I'm not going to go to 5. That's good. So Underground Sea, Deathrite Shaman. Sometimes the reanimator deck can fold to a turn one Deathrite Shaman, but this deck is pretty fast and explosive, so I wouldn't be surprised if my opponent just goes off here and puts a Grizzlebrand into play. Sure. So I think brainstorming is a nice idea. And then I think I want to put back Savannah. Well, maybe Bayou and Swords to Plowshares. Put back Bayou, put back Swords to Plowshares, play Polluted Delta. Now I'll grab Bayou and exile that Thoughtseize. Go Deathrite Shamans. My opponent is just giving this Deathrite Shaman -2/-2, not discarding another card, so I think I'm probably fine with that. Just gonna eat the brainstorm in response. Reanimating Leovold? Huh. Do I care about that? That would put my opponent down to 9, and then I would win the race with what's on the board. Might be fine to let that resolve. My opponent goes down to 9, and then it's 5 activations with Deathrite Shaman. Sure. Could also cast this Jace. And I guess I'd have to Fate Seal myself because otherwise Leovold would. Well, I can also bounce the Leovold. That's pretty good. But do I want to be down to just one Force of Will as my only disruption? My opponent would definitely need 2 cards in order to combo off. And I would have a Jace in play, which is pretty good against most things he or she could reanimate. Alright, yeah, I think I don't want to be too passive here, so I'm going to cast the Jace. And I'm going to Fate Seal myself. I can bounce Leovold next turn, but for now, I don't want to give my opponent an extra card on the crucial moment where I'm tapped out. All right, I guess I can leave that on top. It's really hard to predict what's going to happen in a game like this. Sure. Okay, now I bounce Leovold. My opponent gets to draw one card, that's fine. Now I cast Leovold, holding up Deathrite Shaman for Flusterstorm and a Force of Will. Pretty decent shape here. Drop Decay on Deathrite Shaman. I guess I'll draw my card first. Eat the Bloodstained Mire for blue mana. And then, if nothing else happens, I Brainstorm. Sure. Resolves. Alright, now I gotta find some action, so I'll brainstorm before anything else. Probably want to get rid of these two lands, and then... Is Wasteland my best bet here? Better to Wasteland or to Shuffle and Brainstorm? Probably just Wasteland. So you two go to the top. I destroy the Badlands. Cast Noble Hierarch and get in for four. And I think it's going to be tough for my opponent to win from here with three life to work with and a Flusterstorm to fight through. Okay, 1-1, but here's a tough game where I have to be on the draw. I did like the way I had sideboarded. I mean, I could even bring in the Submerge. It's not that bad because, at worst, it's a blue card to pitch to Force of Will. Don't think I want to bring in any of these non-blue cards, though. And was there anything that wasn't good? I guess Swords to Plowshares would probably be the only real concern. Maybe board out one Noble Hierarch or something like that. Or a land, a basic forest. Yeah, you know, cutting a basic forest for another true name might be worthwhile. Okay. Well, this is a bit dicey, as I have no Force of Will, and I only have one land, but I think I should keep it on the strength of turn two, rest in peace. I have a Swords to Plowshares for some specific types of draws my opponent could have. It's fairly resilient to Thoughtseize, since I have Brainstorm and Ponder. It's not the best hand in the world, but I do think that I should keep it. What? So the first spell I cast is countered unless I pay one. Sure. Takes away my swords to plowshares. All right. So I guess now I ponder and get the ponder countered. Okay. So I'm facing down a 4/6 flyer that counters my spells unless I pay extra. It's gonna be tough. That would have been nice a turn ago. Don't think there's any way I can race this with True Name Nemesises. So I'm gonna have to find a Jace, but that cost me 5 mana. My one other copy of Swords to Plowshares. Maybe Deathrite Shaman can help me gain some life. That's fairly far-fetched, though. Yeah, this is looking tough if I don't find my one other Swords to Plowshares. I don't have any flying creatures to block with. I boarded out my Abrupt Decays to be able to kill the Animate Dead. Probably just want Tropical Island here. Okay. Well, that's a decent start. So on my turn, I get to shuffle away one card with the Misty Rainforest, and I get to play Deathrite Shaman. Seems like Daze is the worst card in this situation. Maybe Daze is better than the third creature here. Sure. Ooh. That's bad. Yeah, I think I'm likely just done now. Go to 9. I have to hit my one Swords to Plowshares. Cast a 2-mana Brainstorm. Then I can cast a 2-mana Swords to Plowshares if I find it. Looks like it's not going to be good enough. Put back two things. I can shuffle, ponder, only 1 mana left over. Nothing I can find to answer the Chancellor. Didn't bring in the Submerge. So, yep, that's it. Pretty close match, but I do fall down to 2-1.